بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم ما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى tonight is our weekly meeting with the fiqh. As we said at the beginning, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith reported on the authority of سيدنا Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with both of them, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to do good to somebody, he makes him understand the religion. يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. طيب, the first time we talked about the difference between fiqh as a branch of knowledge and as a shara'i law and the man-made laws. And we, to summarize the whole thing, it's the idea of the halal and haram. يعني using the term itself with your people, with your kids, is very important. Like I can't say, is it a bird or a text message? So يعني you can keep saying wrong and right, wrong and right, wrong and right. But once you have this sense and this usage with them, it makes big difference, which is haram and halal. And as I said, we're not just doing or like misusing the word halal and haram like some people do. Everything is haram, everything is halal, everything is haram, everything is haram. We use it when it is needed only. Last week, I said, you know what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves you as a Muslim to be in a good shape inside and outside. Inside, you know what, cannot be discussed too much in fiqh, which is taharat al-qalb. It needs some of the raqa'iq, and we'll talk about this inshallah ta'ala in a different time. But outside, outside appearance of the Muslim, the cleanliness of his body, the cleanliness of his clothes, the cleanliness of his house, the cleanliness of the place that he prays in, the cleanliness of the masjid, the cleanliness even of the environment that you live in, it's your responsibility. And you have to make an effort to make sure that everything that you deal with, starting with your own body, is clean. That's why before talking about the tahara, the purification or cleanliness, I prefer to start with what we talked about last week. Who remembers? Fitra. Sunan al-Fitra. Now, the topic, I asked about the topic, one brother gave me the topic. So who's going to give me the hadith? The main hadith that we had last week. I have different audience anyway, but wallah, I don't like it this way. So, to be honest with you, like few brothers here, few brothers there. But you guys should have been a inshallah, next time I'll get you some candy, inshallah, or something like that to get you closer, inshallah. Ma tiga Abrahim hina, Abrahim, inta Allah khir li gamin. Ma tiga ya Am hina. I know I'm pushy, I'm sometimes aggressive. Okay. We said last week that the Prophet ﷺ has two main hadith about the importance of sunan al-fitra. Can you give me one of these hadith? One. He said in one hadith, five things. And in another hadith said 10 things. Give me the five things. ما هي سنة الفطرة? He said صلى الله عليه وسلم خمس من الفطرة. يلا. الاستحداد. What's الاستحداد? Do you remember الاستحداد? مش موجود الاستحداد? انت كنت هنا last week? Really? That was the first thing that we started with. الاستحداد, it is the shaving the pubic hair. حلق العين. والختان, circumcision. ونتف الإبط, plucking the armpit hair. وقص الأظافر, so to cut the nails. And trimming the mustache. وقص الشفايف. Five things, and then the hadith of the 10 things, خلاص كفاية عليك كده, you guys have to look for it and you do some effort for that inshallah ta'ala, because if I talked about it, خلاص, I will be losing it 5 more minutes. But in general, I said that this is the first thing that you have to start with. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave you 40 days limit. He said, as Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik said in the authentic hadith, وَقْتَتَ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us the time limit is 40 days. So all of these things, put the khitan aside, the circumcision aside, and trimming the mustache, the other three things, 40 days maximum. After that, as the ulama said, it will be undesirable, makruh, it's not haram. Because we're talking about sunnah at the end of the day. Unless it will be haram, unless it will be haram in one case. If any of these things is a barrier between you and perfecting your tahara. يعني somebody has lots of the armpit hair, and whenever he goes for ghusl after the janaba, the water does not reach the skin. This way, in this case, becomes haram on you, and you have to take care of that. And this is something you have to think of it now. It's not for the prayer. You're not getting ready for the prayer. It's in general, you have to take care of these parts of your body as part of Sunan al-Fitra, as I said. طيب. الطهارة للصلاة. This is that what I'm going to start talking about, inshallah, from today. Getting pure or clean for prayer. طهارة للصلاة. يعني before I pray, what do you think what we should do? Not we should, we have to do. What do you think we have to do? Wudu, right? That's it, right? خلاص انا بروح اتوضى وخلاص فانا هاجي with my clothes not clean and I'll come like somebody is يعني had a relationship with the wife and you know what, I'll just make wudu and I pray, or somebody else his clothes he touched one of the najasa like impurities, then he makes wudu, he will be okay, right? Right, huh? Wrong. From which do I have to clean myself? يعني مما يتطهر الإنسان. From which? From يعني what are the things that you have to clean yourself from if you are thinking of the prayer? النجاسة. So today I'm going to start with this because you cannot jump to something. It's when it comes to fiqh, everything is built on one another. Like before the tahara has to come the najasa. There is najasa that I have to clean first. And then the tahara comes, after the tahara the surah comes, and then after that the najasa again and the tahara again and the surah again, and that's a cycle that we have in our life. طيب. ينبغي على كل مسلم. It is obligatory upon every single Muslim to clean themselves from all types of impurities to get ready for the salah. Not only upon you. حتى they said that we have to teach our kids the way of tahara from the age of 7. And they have to be, we يعني start getting tough on them when they reach the age of exactly the salah. ما هو, how can he pray? If he cannot clean himself in the bathroom well, how can he pray? So I have to teach him the purification, how to purify and clean himself at the age of 7, at the age of 10, I have to be very tough with him. Very tough. Take it seriously. That's why alhamdulillah we see all the boys are here. طبعا كلهم, all of them are on the iPad at home. الحمد لله حتى كسروا لي الايباد. They broke it, الحمد لله. They either video games or iPad or TV. Did they pray or not? يا اخي الحمد لله they're okay. والله my kids are very good. ما شاء الله very good. Did they pray? No. Do they have to pray? He's still 13. احنا بنيجي على رمضان المصيبة بتطلع بقى في رمضان. The problem comes in رمضان. ما شاء الله a man stronger and taller than you. And you know what, he can know, he study. Wallahi, he goes to school, he wakes up in the, like 7 in the morning, and he stays until 3 p.m. at school,
يا شيخ it's hard on him to fast. صح؟ It's hard. He will never fast by the way. If you don't follow the direction of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and teach him gradually. يا أخي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us 3 years. Not one day, not one month, not 3 months, not a year, not two, 3 years. A period of time to get them used to it. To teach them and take it easy on them. But at a certain point, they have to understand that it's something obligatory upon them and they have to follow. But they said, all the Muslims, including those kids, they have to understand the importance of that, cleaning themselves from the najasa. What are the najasat? طيب أنا بسألك السؤال ده قبل ما أقول اللي عندي يعني what do you think the impurities what do you think the najas like إيه زي إيه بالضبط ها يلا البول ماشي
الغائط
الجنابة يعني الجنابة فيها مشكلة شوية أنا بتكلم على شيء نجس نفسه
الدم
الدم ها
الكلمة
دي لعاب الكلب وإيه تاني Should I pick up the phone for you? الخمر على فكرة مش بلاش نتكلم في الخمر خلينا نتكلم في حاجة حلوة. ها؟ When the phone rings in the masjid too. دم الحيض. يعني ما شاء الله يعني all what we mentioned, so I have a list of them and then we'll see why they are impurities. And how should we clean that impurities? Because sometimes we go hard on ourselves. يعني you're carrying your nephew, a little boy, and he bees on you. You have to take hold on. There's a way. يعني it's a little bit. You can do a easy way, for example, and to clean yourself. We'll talk about this. With the girl is different, as we will know. The first thing of the najasat, الخنزير ولحمه. عظمه وشعره وجلده. So the pigs, everything related to pigs. The meat, the bones, the hair, and the skin, unless it is tanned. You know the tanning? Not the tanning that they do over here. You know the tanning that they do, like they go and they wanna be East Indian or Egyptian. So they're white and they wanna change the color of the skin. No, the tanning when you get the skin and you change the nature of the skin. So everything of this is type of najasat. Everything relevant to the pigs, طبعاً except the halal pork. Okay. Have you guys tried it? You didn't, right? Alhamdulillah. طيب. بول الإنسان صغيراً أم كبيراً ذكراً أم أنثى. So the urine of the human being, man or woman, young or old in age, it's all impurities. How to clean that? We'll mention later, inshallah. غائط الإنسان. So number two. Man, woman, old, the feces, or number two. Okay, دم الحيض ودم النفاس. The blood of both the menstruation or the menses and the postnatal period that happens after the birth of the baby. لعاب الكلب وعرقه. So the saliva, because some people, if he is like, like some brothers, for example, they go serve. حتى عنده كلب هنا. Anybody has a dog at home here? Nobody? So, طيب, when it is halal to have a dog, by the way? Let's stop here. When it's halal to have it? استنى نشوف ابن تمن يقول ايه. Guard? ما شاء الله عليك حبيبي. But inside the house, no. Outside the house. That's it. And كلب الحراس وكلب الصيد. يعني, and this is will come later on, inshallah ta'ala. But having a dog inside the house, we don't have this at all, and it's haram. يعني you go this way, you come this way, no way to have the dog at home. And I have this problem, you know, with whom? With the new Muslim sisters. Because they accept Islam. By the way, some of them, they knew that having the dog inside the house will be haram in Islam. I think they will change their mind. If it be before, But they become Muslims and they still keep the dog inside, and it's very hard to convince them. يعني you need to take good time, years, to be honest with you, years of time to convince them in a nice way that having the dog inside, it's يعني something haram in Islam. Anyway, it's not the dog itself, like the khanzir, like the pig. It's not like that, or the pig. It is the saliva and the sweat of the dog. خلاص؟ يعني don't play with them. بول ورغث ما لا يؤكل لحم. يعني you have something at home. You have you know what back home we raise the chicken and the ducks and these things. The rawath, their feces, whatever you call it, it's halal. But if animals that it's not halal to eat their meat, it's haram. Their urine and feces will be haram, will be najis, will be impure, or part or type of najas. بَوْلُ وَرَفَثْ مَا لَا يُؤْكَلْ لَحْمُ مِنَ الْحَيَوَانَاتِ وَالطُّيُورِ مِثْلَ الْحِمَارِ وَالْبَغْلِ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. Okay. There is something that comes after or with the lost. Somebody is يعني thinking in a desire, with a desire, something called مَذِي. Have you heard of that? المَذِي. المَذِي comes with the thinking, with the desire, when a man thinks about يعني something. So this is also impurity, but how to clean yourself from? I'll mention it later, inshallah. And then we'll leave some for the question too.
والوادي. This is different from المذي.
Yeah, أنا عندي المن, المذي, الوادي. Okay? الوادي is something that comes usually when somebody is sick or comes after urination. After you finish urination, little thing comes. It's different from the urine. It comes out, and sometimes when somebody is sick, it comes too. But it's still part of type of impurities from the najas. والقيء الذي يملأ الفم, like when you vomit and when you throw up, big thing coming out of your body. If a little thing, it's fine. But big thing meaning that it comes from your stomach, your tummy. So becomes impurity too. صقر الكلب وهو ما يبقى في إناء بعد شرب الكلب منه لأن لعابه نجس. So there a dog drinks from a vessel, and whatever left is impure. Impure mean يعني impurity means that impossible to use this to clean yourself or as a tahir thing. Okay. طيب وسقر الخنزير, the same, whatever remains after the pigs eat drink from the water, whatever remains becomes impure or najis. ولحم الميتة, يعني you cannot eat, for example, the fish until it is slaughtered, right? The halal way?
No.
Why? And we have a lots of Bangladeshi and Pakistani and Indian over here. So you guys, it has to be, and we have few Muslims here. Alhamdulillah, everybody's Muslim. So, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam يقول هو الحل الطهور ماءه الحل ميتته. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam يقول في حديث آخر أحل لكم ميتتان ودمان. Do you remember, do you know that hadith? That there are two. I said that hadith with a member around a couple of months ago, over here in the MCE. He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, there are two types. The dead meat of the dead animals are haram, except two things. Two dead things that we can eat. Like, yeah, Abdullah. Two dead things that you can eat them without slaughter. Duck? No, no, duck. No. السمك. الخنزير, الخنزير يا عم. No, أنا بقول حلال. حل لكم ميتتان ودمان. أنا عاوز الاثنين الميتتان. نو مش الصيد. أيوة 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 اللوكست. You know the جراد. Locust. Two things. The fish you eat it as dead, and the locust. And this came in the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. You know locust? يعني when you look at it, it looks disgusting. But some people they eat it and you can eat it dead actually. الجراد. طب ما هم الدمان؟ والدم it's all حرام. It's all impure and حرام to eat except two things. الكبد والطحال. The liver and the spleen. Two things that you can eat. So part of the impurities is لحم الميتة itself. It's impure. If the touch here, it will be a problem. ويراد به هنا كل حيوان يعيش في البر له دم سائل. Okay. بغير إذا مات بغير تذكية شرعية. فما يعيش في البحر كالسمك بأنواعه إذا مات لا يصير نجسا. وما ليس له دم سائل مثل الذباب والبعوض والنمل والصراصير إذا مات لا يكون نجسا. سبحان الله. Because it doesn't. If the animal has blood, so when you slaughter it, blood comes out. So this, if it dies, it becomes impure and haram to eat for sure. But if it doesn't have a running blood, like the flies and the ants and the صراصير يعني الله ما أعرف. If it dies, it's not considered to be. And we don't consider it as impurities because it doesn't have blood running after it dies. Okay? طيب. والدم الذبيحة. يعني somebody slaughtering in Eid, so the blood comes in your cloth, becomes impurities, and you have to clean your cloth. طبعا هيبصوا يشوفوا يقول لك ده اللحامين عندنا بيخشوا الجامع وهم. Oh, there is something here about it. The blood itself is najis, but when you clean it, you don't have to take even the color. So the color sometimes stays, but you take the impurity, you take the blood itself. But sometimes, يعني some of the colors remains of the body and should be okay. And I'm gonna يعني talk about this in details, inshallah. Many of the insan, the semen of the man, while you know, although al-Shafi'iyya and Hanabila, both of them, they said it's tahir. يعني the Shafi'iyya and the Hanabila, the Shafi'i school and the Hanbali school, they both they said that the mani or the semen is pure, it's not impure. You know why? What happened is, Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, when she used to clean the cloth of the Prophet of the Prophet from the mani, they said that she used to تفركة يعني scrub right? Scrub it a little bit and pour some water on it. طيب if it is dry she didn't even use to put any water, just scrub it a little bit and that's it. So and sometimes she used to, if it is wet she used to clean it. That's why the ulama they said that if it was impure, then even if it is dry, she had to clean it. But the others who said that it's impurity, they said that it is impure, but it's not a condition to clean it if it's dry. So both ways are okay, and it's two main of the and two of the main schools of thought. They said it's tahir. So for you to take whatever you can, يعني you wanna follow, يعني both. ما قطع من البهيمة وهي حية فهو ميتة نجسة. يعني an animal that you can eat, sheep or whatever, and you there is a limb is cut, this limb is impure. Even it's halal when you slaughter it to eat it, but if it's cut without slaughtering the animal, will become impure. طيب. How these are the list of the impurities that we have. Do you remember any other of the impurities that I miss? Maybe you add to us. Talk. تكلم بجد. حصان. يعني أنت قصدك تقولي إن لحم الجمل impure؟ Yeah, بس أنا ما بقولش الموجبات للوضوء أو الموجبات للغسل. أنا ما بقولش كده. أنا بقول this thing is impure itself. هو نجاسة itself. فجزاك الله خيرا. وإن كنت طبعا أنت عارف الحديث نفسه في خلاف. You know the hadith of eating the camel meat is a يعني حديث that some scholars they understand it this يعني one way and the other they understand it different way. خلاص يعني we don't have camel meat in Canada so don't worry about it. فمن أكل لحم جادوري فليتوضأ. You know what happened? That they said that one of the Sahaba was in the masjid and he passed gas. So he just ate the camel meat. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that من أكل whoever ate a camel meat he should make wudu. But some scholars they said that it's the text itself as it is. You know what? Whenever you eat a camel meat, your wudu is broken. And some others they said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so nice to this Sahabi, and instead of like telling him, you know what, come here, go make your wudu because we smell, you know what, something from you. He said it in a way to, يعني, as a respect for the Sahabi. Both ways are okay, inshallah ta'ala. طيب, how to clean any of these najasat? I'll give you a very simple qa'idah. It's a very simple rule. If the najasa is taken away in any way, you should be okay. Any of these najasat. For example, I carried a part of the pork, for example. A pork meat. I'm carrying it right now. It didn't leave on my hand like that. Okay? Then I hand it to somebody. What should I do? Clean my hand. خلاص. No effect and no remains of that najasa. خلاص, I'm okay. I don't have to cut my hand, for example, because I carried this. Or to go take a shower for this. يعني sometimes we go extreme when it comes to cleaning yourself from a najasa. فالقاعدة بتقول ايه؟ إزالة النجاسة حتى لا يبقى ما يدل إزالة أثر النجاسة حتى لا يبقى ما يدل عليها من طعم أو لون أو راحية أو رائحة إلا إذا تعذر شيء من ذلك فإنه يعفى عنه مثل الدم الذي يتعذر على الإنسان إزالة لونه. So the قاعدة, the rules, the general rule says that when you take this نجاسة off, you should be okay. But mean off meaning that there is no smell or color or anything relevant to this najasa stain on you or your cloth, unless it's hard to take it off. Like the blood, I was talking earlier about the blood. The color of the blood, يعني you need يعني lots of different materials to take it off, but if you clean it with water, you still should be okay. Sometimes, مثلا, you come, you wash your cloth, يعني you bleed a little bit, then the blood was there, and you wash your clothes and you come to the masjid and you look at your clothes, there is a little bit of blood. It's not the blood, it's the color itself. You should be okay. Unless you're able to take it off or to delete it or take this najasa off at all, including the color, you should do that. But sometimes the remains stays there and you're okay to use your clothes at that time. وبناء على هذه القاعدة يقول إذا صابنا الماء على البول ولو مرة واحدة فزالت رائحته فقد حصلت الطهارة. You know the Sahabi who came to the masjid. Remember that? طبعا hopefully we don't have a brother come to the same life. This Sahabi. This Sahabi came to the masjid and he take a corner and he urinate. طبعا لو حصلت هنا هنجيب له RCP. He will be in jail right away. طبعا طبعا we'll do that. No tolerance with that, zero tolerance. So this Sahabi came and he urinated in the corner of the masjid. So the Prophet ﷺ told him, leave him until he finished first. And then after, just bring some water and pour it on that urine and should be okay. So this water, the pure water or the fresh water or the clean water, takes the impurity of that water and it's done. Okay? Unless you can't. يعني it's on the carpet, for example. One of those boys, mashallah, he didn't have his diaper. The father forget to put his diaper or to change his diaper at home, because it's your job, right? Your job to change. Don't say no. You all changed diaper before. Who didn't change diaper before? And he asked it. Kullu change diaper. I'm telling you. Anyway, so in changing the diaper, you did it, and the kid came here. It's not enough to pour the water. You have to make sure that you're taking this out or off the carpet in a way, and whatever it is. You put some soap, whatever, and or any material to take that off and use something else to take the impurity off the carpet. وإذا صببنا الماء على سجاد ومثله متنجس ثم جذبنا الماء بخرق أو سفنجة وكررنا ذلك حتى زالت الرائحة فقد حصلت الطهارة. That's exactly what I was saying right now in English, that if it is on the sand, it's different from the carpet floor. You have to use something to take it off. طيب. ألك وجلد الميتة يطهر بالدبار tanning. طيب والخف, and this is very common. My shoes, while I'm coming walking to the masjid, had some impurity. What should I do? طبعاً على طول throw them away. خلاص get a new shoe. صح؟ Just leave them in the masjid, inshallah. They will send them for you. It's all what you need to do is to make sure that you cleaned the bottom of the shoe. That's it. You don't have to wash it. But there is no remains, you're fine. You're okay. Okay? طيب. وإزالة النجاسة بعد التبول أو التبرز يكفي باستعمال خلاص. يعني some people they said when you urinate, use the bathroom for number one, number two. Sometimes use the, يعني خلينا, let's talk about our situation now. I think, والله أعلم, it's not enough to use the cleaners or the paper, or the toilet paper, whatever we use. Outside. So we have to use the water because the water is everywhere. خلاص. It's your responsibility to make sure that you take water with you. And it's not hard anywhere you are right now to take water. Back in the days they used to do the little stones to clean themselves and they add water after that. And sometimes if they don't have water, it was enough for them to do the stones. It's fine, but they didn't have all what we have right now. So I would say, inshallah ta'ala, don't يعني, do anything but water. Water until, like the ulama said, and inshallah I'm going to talk in details about this. I didn't talk about using the bathroom. I'm talking about deleting or eliminating or taking the najasa off. Only taking the najasa off. The ulama said that when you use the bathroom, you have to feel the dryness of the spot or the place after using the water. And if it's still there is liquids or something like that, you have to make sure that it's so dry before you go for your wudu, inshallah ta'ala. طيب. وبول الصبي الذكر. خلاص, you have a girl, a baby girl, and a baby boy. The urination or the urine of the little boy can be taken if it comes in your clothes by just pouring some water on it. The girl not. The girl, you have to wash the whole thing. That's why it's very, why we're not biased, Brother Fahim. We're not biased. You know why? Who can explain to me why? Why the urine of the little boy who's still a little boy, and I'm talking about a baby who still, يعني, his mom breastfeed him, and a girl that her mom still breastfeed her. Why it's different between the girl and the boy? Did you read about it before? طب, do you know that ruling? That it's different? You know it. طب, why? فالصبية فيغسل الثوب من بولها كما يغسل. So we treat, or we deal with the urine of the little baby girl exactly like the urine of an old boy, old man, old woman, the same. Why? طب, can I leave it as an assignment for you?
No.
It's a scientific fact. Because the urine of the girl, when it comes with some discharge, that female discharge. So it's not only the urine; it's other discharges that the nature of the women, the females, different from the man. That's why we treat it differently, because other impurities comes with it. Okay, and that's what I read about it before.
You have to clean the whole. Not that part, I mean the whole
part. Yeah, I have this, we say Jalabiya in Egypt, and we say Dishdasha in Syria, and Lebanon and Palestine, they say Dishdasha. I have this Dishdasha.
Yeah.
So my baby girl, she urinates on this part. Yeah. I have to clean the whole thing.
The whole
thing? Yeah, I have to take it off.
Okay.
And make sure that I wash it.
Okay.
But my boy, baby boy, urinate on me, I'll just give some water, clean it, I'm okay. And this is in the hadith, and we have the hadith, by the way, because some people will just like, look at me now. Let's take the hadith that support what we have said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the anything relevant to the pigs, he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَوْ لَحْمَ قِنْزِيرٍ فَإِنَّهُ إِيه؟ رِجْس. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the pigs to be impurities, anything relevant to them. طيب, about the urination. And I said that hadith earlier, this man who came to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he urinated, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered this sahabi who tried to stop him, don't stop him, and he ordered another man to bring some water and just spray it or to pour it on that. And this is authentic hadith. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the little boy and the little girl. يُغْسَلُ مِن بَوْلِ الْجَارِيَةِ وَيُرَشُّ مِن بَوْلِ الْغُلَامِ. And this hadith, رواه أبو داود والنسائي. Prophet ﷺ said that from the urine of the little baby girl, you need to wash the whole piece of cloth, and from the urine of the little boy, just pour some water or spray some water on it. Okay? طيب. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا ذهب أحدكم إلى الغائط فليذهب معه بثلاثة أحجار يستطيب بهن أو يتطهر بهن فإنها تجزي عنه. يعني the main thing is to use the stones when you go to use the bathroom in the number two. But again, we have the water, as I explained earlier, it's better to have the water. طيب. دم الحيض, the blood of the menstruation, is impure. Najis. But how to clean it? Very simple. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا صاب ثوب إحداكن الدم من الحيضة فلتقرضه تدلكه بأطراف الأصابع بالماء ثم لتنضحه بالماء ثم تصلي فيه. So again you treat and you deal with the blood of the menstruation exactly as you deal with the urine. Not you, you deal, you don't محدش فيه خلاص مش كده. So it's only 35 minutes and I said this today we have 1 hour for the fiqh inshallah ta'ala. But for the sisters and for yani to tell your wife, sometimes, for example, a little bit of the menstruation blood comes on the pole. Then she put it on a side, then she got, alhamdulillah, pure, not pure, clean from the menstruation, and she want to have this piece of cloth again, she want to put it on. But it has a little bit of the the menstruation blood. The Prophet ﷺ said that you can, as we said earlier, grasp it or say scrub it a little bit and put some water on it and she should be okay. She doesn't have to wash the whole clothes as the Prophet ﷺ said. طيب. The problem when you have a dog and the dog drinks from the water becomes impure along with the vessel itself. And it has to be washed for 7 times. Has to be washed for 7 times. If you know that a dog, can you keep the questions until I finish? Then we'll take all the questions, but don't forget, write it on your hand. Okay? I'm almost done. So, طهور إناء أحدكم. خليها معاك يا سامي.
One time with Sam, أضيف.
No, مش أولهن بالتراب. The first one with the, not sand, dust. Dirt, sorry, with dirt. So يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم طهوروا إناء أحدكم إذا ولغ فيه الكلب أن يغسله 7 مرات أولهن بالتراب. So if you know that there is a dog, your neighbor dog, drink from this cup or wherever it is. So it's not enough that I put it in the dishwasher. It's not enough. I have to make sure that I clean it or I wash it 7 times because of the dog. That's why you're going to have dogs. You know, we're going to have dogs. طيب. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم عن المذي. So I said earlier, I have المذ, الوات, and المني. What are المذ? What is المذ? نسينا.
After
what?
Urine.
No, that's الوادي. Yeah, with the thinking. The one comes with a desire called المذي. And the Prophet ﷺ said, فيه الوضوء. Again, as we said earlier, the brother was talking about camel meat, he left. We said earlier, I'm not talking about the things that you have to make wudu from or make ghusl from. I'm talking about the najasa, how you take it off. The madhi is a najasa. How you take it off, you clean yourself, and what you do after to get ready for the salah, only al wudu. So you don't have to make ghusl after madhi or wadi, only wudu, and we'll talk about this inshallah in detail too. طيب. وسؤر الكلب نجس.
You have to clean the cloth as well.
Absolutely. هو, I'm talking about the najasa attached to the body or to the cloth. Yeah. How to take it off, you clean it and that's it. Or you scrub it. وسؤر الكلب نجس وسؤر الخنزير نجس. So the water remains after the dog's drink or after the pig's drink is najas too and you cannot use it. And we talked about this. طيب. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دبغ الإهاب فقد طهر ودباغ جلود الميتة طهورها. So any skin of a dead animal, if you tan it, it will be pure. It is impure, it is najasa by itself, and you leave it in the street, but if you want to use it, you tan it, it will be useful, and it will be inshallah ta'ala طاهرة. طيب.
In case of dead animals, are those which are not halal as well?
The skin yeah. of the halal, the thing that you slaughter is pure, it's yeah, not yeah, impure. Yeah. Only the dead.
But what about those which are not halal animals? So their skin, tanned skins is not halal.
If you tan it, it will be halal.
Even for those which are
halal. Even the khanzir. Yeah. If you tan it, you change the nature of the khanzir, and it's I think it's in some of the leathers comes from the khanzir, right? Or not? Yes. It is. There is. Yeah, they use it.
But there is a skill, I think, because some.
But there is. Yani, a good number of scholars. They said it's okay. Hatta they even some of the medications has pork in it. A little bit gelatin from pork, and they said if you don't have any alternative, you still can take it. In some cases, but the tanned. Leather or the leather comes from the tanned skin of the khanzir should be okay. Wallahu a'lam. طيب. يعني we talked about the semen, how you take it off and how the Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha used to do with it. إذا جاء أحدكم إلى المسجد about the shoes. إذا جاء when somebody comes to the masjid فليقلب عليه. Let's look at the bottom of his shoe. فإن وجد خبثا فليمسحه بالأرض وليصلي فيهما. So if you find anything, any dirt at the bottom of your shoes, just grasp it again or scrub it in the dirt, and even you can pray. Can I pray while I'm using? I have the shoes on or not?
Yeah.
Allah Farid. But not in the masjid. سنتيكم لكم الشوز بكرة كله يكسل على الباب ويخش هنا.
في حديث عن الرسول
صلى الله عليه وسلم
كان لابس الحذاء وجاء سيدنا جبريل وقال له انزع فنزعه الصحابة ايضا كان في نجاسة.
انت عارف ان ده حديث؟
حديث
انا اول مرة اسمع بس هل هو حديث ام لا؟ Yeah, let me double check it, Sam. Because I really doubt the authenticity of that hadith. But we'll double check it, inshallah, first, and then we'll talk about it. To be honest with you, I have two more pages relevant to that. But I'll leave them to next week, inshallah. But now we'll take some questions from you again. عشان بس يعني الأمور تبقى واضحة. To make it clear, we're not talking about getting or يعني what are the things that entails you to make wudu and things that entails you to make ghusl. I'm talking about the impurity itself and how you take it off if it's on your body or on your clothes. طيب, any question about these impurities before inshallah ta'ala we go to a different area or different topic? Go ahead, Amma.
Yeah, if you go to say a friend's house and they have dog.
ما هو الكلب على طول؟
سبحان
الله. I don't feel comfortable صراحة. I don't stay.
Yeah, sometimes you don't feel comfortable. You have to stay and then.
And be careful, Allah. If you talk badly about the dog, you will be in trouble.
Okay.
مصيبه. والله مصيبه. We had a principle. Those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ابتلاهم with this مصيبه. We had a principal at the Islamic school in the States, and they asked him. We were in the room, like the lunch time, and one of the teacher asked him. His name was Douglas, and they used to call him Doug, Mr. Doug. How many kids you have? Wallahi al-Azim, Alina, I have two dogs. He had two dogs. That's his kids. Anyway, فسؤالك, what is it? If you're not sure, you have to make sure and need to check, and you have to. يعني I would say you change that and wash it. يعني how you not sure?
بس
like that, خلاص it's done.
Okay.
That even some scholar, you know what, the stone is not only that. And to be honest with you, I was not aware of this until today. I always was thinking, and that's why, Akhwana, you might think it's a very simple topic, right? It's a very simple stuff that you're talking about. We might think that. But wallahi, the more you read, the more you find out that there are stuff that you missed. We miss a lot. So you fill the gaps when you attend class like that. So all the time I was under the impression it's only that, the saliva. Today I found out that scholar, they said even the sweat. عرق الكلب. العرق بتاع الكلب is not طاهر. Even the sweat of the كلب, the dog, is not pure.
يعني
الكلب
يكون
والله أنا, I would say if I go and I know that for sure that he has dogs. And the dogs touch this place that I'm sitting at, I will wash this cloth. I will never pray with this. No. With the clothes, just put it and use the soap and everything, the stuff that we use, and should be okay, inshallah. وبعدين get rid of the dog that you have at home, ya Allah. You have to kill it. Not kill ya Allah.
You were talking about.
What do you mean by far from home?
Like, it's happened to me one time. I went fishing, and people were fishing beside me. They are bringing their dogs, and the dog come beside me. I tried to actually can you keep your dog away, but the dog sit down and he touched me.
He can't train. You mean the saliva?
No, just with this. What you said, Arab.
No, but al-araq means that you feel it. There is a wet thing when you're close. If the dog is only the hair of the dog comes on you, you're fine. You're fine. You don't have to worry about anything. But I'm talking about the sweat al-araq. You feel wet thing comes on your clothes. Or the saliva. It both wet. Both wet comes on your clothes. You have to take care of that. But then you turn outside, but take it off and wash it. The water of the sea, of the lake, it's fresh and pure, so you can wash it. Yeah? Allah,
brother. Some people, they get some issue with urine system.
Yeah. بيقول لك عليه, بيقولوا عليه, we'll talk about this later, but let's, يعني, attack. Sometimes, some people, I don't know the name of that disease in English, but they call it salicyl bowel. So salicyl bowel, when somebody cannot control his urine. So he makes wudu, whenever he goes for ruku or sujood, he feels something comes out. It's a type of sickness that you don't have to worry about it while prayer. It does not invalidate your prayer, but you have to make wudu for every salah. You cannot pray two salah with one wudu if you have this type of disease. You have to make wudu. Yeah, you clean yourself, then you pour water, a little bit of water in the underwear, and then you make sure that you make wudu for every salah. But if it happens during the prayer itself, don't leave the salah. Your salah. Your salah is valuable. Okay?
It's called incontinence.
Incontinence. Allah. خلاص انت قلت سؤالك؟
لا انا قلت يا حتى السلطيبي الفيلاد يعني approved by medicine that caused the cancer or chest wound, cancer chest wound. The
yeah, breast cancer. والله الحمد لله ما عندناش كلاب هنا وما دير اوكي ان شاء الله. I'm assuming يعني. Nobody has dog at home. تفضل يا اخي. I'll come back to your show.
So you are talking about halal things, which two things which are dead, but even those are halal. So regarding fish, if someone already found fish dead in the water or on the
oh, dead in the water and spills, halal, you don't eat it.
Means those are not halal.
ويحرم عليهم الخبائث, becomes harmful.
Means those fishes which are already dead, so those are not halal.
Yeah, halal is dead in the water.
Yes, yeah. And as that brother was asking a question. So if the water.
But by the way, Manish, sorry. There is some people, they think that only the fish in the water is halal. So you don't eat, they don't eat shrimp, they don't eat crab legs. I'm telling them, you guys are missing. Wallahi, they are missing. It's halal to eat anything in the water. Hatta if you get a pig and you put it in the water. Yeah, just to add to this,
so shrimps are also and those things.
Shrimp is halal, yeah.
Everything, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I know that a lot. It's a big number of the brothers in India and Pakistan. They don't eat it. I know that. I don't know about Bangladesh yet.
So
you guys eat shrimp.
Yeah.
Some people say.
So this question is linked to that, brother. That if the dog is already wet, because that dog is coming out from the water. And that wet dog, if touch your
no, it's water. It's a different water. It's not coming.
So in that
brother, case, anything comes coming out of the dog. Not.
Again, if you are outside fishing somewhere, you stop prey. And if someone coming with his dog and he touch you with his saliva, you stop the prey.
Oh, well, that's a good question. Imagine.
Because it's.
I
like
that question.
I found the hadith and it has something.
Okay, go ahead. You ask Sheikh Google, Sheikh Google, inshallah.
روى أبو داود في سنن ابن أبي سعيد الخدري قال: بينما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي في أصحابه، خلع عليه فوضعهما عن يساره، فلما رأى ذلك القوم أو يعلم، فلما قضى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاته، قال: ما حملكم على إلقائكم عليكم؟ قالوا: رأيناك ألقيتنا عليك فألقيناك علينا، فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن جبريل عليه السلام أتاني فأخبرني أن فيهما قدرا. وقال:
Yeah, inshallah. So it's an authentic hadith that if you find out during the salah that there is any of your clothes has, yani, the shoes that you're using for while you pray has dirt, you take them off and you continue. But with the clothes, how are you going to take them off? I would say your prayer is invalid and you have to wash them and make sure that they are clean. Because it invalidates the use of fuck.
It may be a funny question. Actually, in old age, you know, the water, the people used to drink, they take water actually from the well.
Yeah.
So if, you know, like dog or cat, it fell down.
Yeah, that's a good question. And actually, I missed it because I had it on me. So if the water, that it's not running water,
yeah.
So a water in a vessel or a well,
yeah.
It gets impure with any of these things, I'll try to take water off until I'm sure that the water becomes clean.
Okay.
How long it takes, how much money it takes, how much water it takes.
At least that much water which usually stays in the
exactly.
Well.
But if it's running water, you just push it and it should be okay, inshallah. It should be tahir, inshallah. Okay, any other? No, ihna khalas. Yeah, but we're saying that it's already changed. There is najasa in the water. If there is najasa in the water, I have to make sure that I'm taking this najasa out of the water. Okay, inshallah ta'ala, next week I'm gonna continue with something relevant to the najasa, and hopefully we go to something, another topic inshallah if we have time. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما علمنا فهو ولي ذلك والقدر عليه. جزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. وشكر الله لكم حسن استماعكم جميعا.